Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. The Vidbute Secondary School has been renamed the Patricia D. James Secondary School, paying homage to the first principal of the school. The rebranding of the school was done in commemoration of its 30th anniversary. Patricia D. James encouraged the students to show pride in their school and what it stands for. Parliamentary Representative for Castries North, Honourable Stevenson King, stated that the standards set by Patricia D. James have bred successful women and men. The ceremony for the rebranding of the school was held on Monday, September 2, 2019, at the school grounds. Residents of Saltibus can look forward to a new road as consultations begin for the community's road reconstruction project. Some 7.6 kilometers of road will be reconstructed from Saltibus to Jetwin. The Overseas Engineering and Construction Company, OECC, will oversee the works while contracts will be awarded to residents of the area. Representatives from the Ministry of Infrastructure, Ports, Energy and Labour, Parliamentary Representative for Schwarzel Saltibus and contractors were all on hand at a community consultation to inform residents of the details of the project as well as alleviate any fears or concerns that they may have. The consultation was held on Monday, September 2, 2019. While a number of issues are still being ironed out, works are tentatively scheduled to start on the 9th of September 2019. In an effort to reduce indiscriminate dumping of waste in the country, the Saint Lucia Hotel and Tourism Association have partnered with the Saint Lucia Solid Waste Management Authority to officially launch a car sticker campaign. The campaign, entitled Gasa You Mad or What, aims to reinforce the correct means to dispose of garbage. Carl Hunter, Environmental Chair for the SLHTA and Property Manager for Jade Mountain, explained that the idea developed following a discussion with interns from the Super Comprehensive School. A total of 1,000 stickers were financed via the Tourism Enhancement Fund and will be made available via the Saint Lucia National Trust, the Saint Lucia Hotel and Tourism Association, and the Solid Waste Management Authority. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.